Welcome to Synchronous Motor Part 9 video. Today let us see the different torques of a synchronous motor. The torques we will be discussing are the starting torque and the running torque, pull in torque and pull out torque. Let us see first one, the starting torque. For the synchronous motor, we will be giving stator voltage and a torque will be developed by the synchronous motor at starting, and that will be known as what? Starting torque. It is also called as breakaway torque. The range of the torque, starting torque, let us say the rated torque of the machine is 10%. Compared to that, this starting torque can be having 10% for the centrifugal pump type motors, and it will be high as 200 to 250 for the compressors. So this is the range of starting torques possible. And let us see the running torque. It is the torque developed under running condition of synchronous motor. Motor is running and it will be having any particular HP. And we know the equation for HP. It is 2 pi NT into divided by 60 into 746. Is it? Now, here the speed it is fixed. Only thing is the torque can be varied. So depending on the HP, the torque can be decided. Based on the capacity or horsepower of the machine, its torque will be specified. And it will be like this from this formula. And based on the HP, we should be giving the maximum running torque. The maximum running torque should be more than the breakdown torque. Okay. And if you are increasing the load more and more, what will happen? Finally, the synchronous motor will stall. What is stalling? It will stop. So if the load is continuously increasing, there will be a maximum condition, that is the breakdown torque. We will be discussing that later. So the running torque should be less than the breakdown torque. Otherwise what will happen? The motor will stop or it will stall. Next is pull in torque. Let us say we will be considering a motor or synchronous motor which is not self-starting, and it will be started as a induction motor. And at starting, the synchronous motor will be having a slip or a synchronous speed which is less than 2 to 5%. So in the starting condition, synchronous motor may not be running at synchronous speed, which will be less than speed of 2 to 5% of the synchronous speed in the method of induction motor starting. And it requires a torque when, so at starting it is having a lesser speed, and with a particular torque it will be catching synchronous speed. So the torque required to get synchronized, that is known as what? That is the pull in torque. So it is the amount of torque at which the motor will get into synchronism, that is known as pull in torque. Next is pull out torque. Let us see. Now, if the motor load is getting increased, we know that rotor will be falling back synchronously. Actually, when the load is increasing, we know that it will be synchronous speed only. The synchronous motor will be running at synchronous speed only, but the rotor will be rolling back. You may be remembering such conditions. They have already been discussed in the part 5 video of synchronous motor, where a light load has been given to the synchronous motor, it will be falling with a small angle between stator poles and rotor poles. If it is heavy load, it will be having falling by large angle. So this is known as load angle. If we are increasing the load angle like this, what will happen? It will be going up to a maximum angle of 90 degree. And don't misunderstand, it is electrical degree 90. It is between two adjacent alternate poles. So if you are having one N and one S, that is known as adjacent alternate poles. Between this halfway, it can maximum have a distance between a stator pole and rotor pole, that is 90 degree. Any further increased load which will cause the motor to stop, that is known as pull out of step, the word it is like that. So we can say that as pull out torque. So it is the maximum torque which the motor can develop without pulling out, it is known as pull out torque. After pull out torque, or when attained pull out torque, it will be stopping. And we were telling about the methods of, or the torques of generally a synchronous motor which is started with use of induction motor. And for synchronous motor which is perfectly synchronous speed only, it we can say the rated torque here, and this one the pull out torque, where we are drawing the, putting the speed and torque. So this is the speed torque characteristics of a synchronous motor.